guys, welcome to Her Essence for another episode. I appreciate your love. Thank you so much for tuning in once again on Wema TV. It's Her Essence and it's with me, Sonny Masharia. Today we talk about things people dating and singles should know about relationships. Joining me today is my amazing guest, Mother. How are you?
I'm so fine, Sonny. And you?
I'm fine, thank you. Mm-hmm. So today, as I had said earlier, we're talking about things we wish people, or the single people and dating people, should know about marriages, mm-hmm, or relationships at a whole, man. Mm-hmm. What are those things?
I'm not going to be biased.
Yeah.
I'm not a hater. Mm-hmm. And I am not a schemer. But I am very particular with this set of people. Christians.
Yeah.
I am a Christian and I don't despite it. But I want us to demystify a few of the things we have taken too far, and yeah, they are really failing so many of the marriages, even in the church spectrum. Yeah. So one of the major things that I'd say has been a turning point and I have learned fundamentally is stop looking for ministry partners. Stop looking for prayer partners. Stop looking for a fellow preacher. Stop looking for those things. Please look for a marriage partner.
Yeah.
Marriage is ministry, but it is a very different level of ministry because it requires somebody who is able to go through it and is able to do it in the expected way.
Yeah.
I need somebody and who we are able to stay with together, who are able to enjoy company. Love. I don't want you to be praying all day and by the time you're done, we can't even look at each other face to face and you think those things are demonic.
Yeah,
my friend, God created relationships so we can enjoy them. He's the main one. He's the main person who created this. It's not like the devil created it. You know, we make it look like God created the earth, animals, and everything apart from relationships. He's the sole creator of relationships.
Yeah.
And when two people become one, better things can be done. But without purpose, worse things can happen. So if you meet and come together and you have a place and a purpose to achieve, of course God is going to bless the both of you.
Yeah.
But as long as two people come together without any designated purpose, trust me, you have given an opening for the enemy. And the same people in the same relationship can achieve a devastating result in the end. So for me, what I'd emphasize is look for marriage partners. And what is this? Look into the character and values of this person.
Yeah.
And this is what actually keeps people in consistency. It's not fasting and praying for 40 days. If I never decide to stop something and I still fast about it, I will still find myself doing the same thing. But if I am able to still, align my character. It is more easier when you are, of course, relying on a higher being. And it is always easier when you're relying on God.
Yeah.
But it is harder when you're doing it on your own. Trust me, that people who have values and character and they are not even in church.
Yeah.
The people who are keeping them and they respect marriage. But Christians are of late becoming so very familiar with it because they have become familiar with the Maker.
Yeah.
So let's understand the purpose of marriage. And when we understand the purpose of marriage, we'll be able to know the dynamics to get through it.
You said about the purpose. I want us to dive into what is the purpose? Because I feel many a times people don't understand the purpose of marriage. That makes it the mistake people make when diving into relationships and marriage thereafter.
Mm-hmm.
What is the sole purpose?
Yes.
Of marriage.
So yes, one, I would want to first say that marriage itself is not a calling, but marriage is a means to the purpose.
Yeah.
Marriage is something you can use to get through with the purpose of God.
Yeah.
So the ultimate thing is normally to accomplish the purpose that is higher than us, but in the process, we get a partner who we can partner with in this life for the purpose of God. And that means the first main thing that God has called for marriage is for us to accomplish His purpose together.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean that I have to look for somebody who will do the same old thing or the same thing that I do, but we need people who we can complement one another and in the end be able to come up with a very good team that will produce good results and in the end be very effective for the kingdom and even in the world. You know, people are just thinking about purpose in terms of, you know, sometimes people look at marriage and they're looking for a fellow, you know, worshiper. We also have jurisdiction areas like I can be called into accounting.
Yeah.
professional field, and I need, you know, somebody who can mentor me in the career area, and we are able to work together and impact the career world. It's not necessary that God calls us to really be on the pulpit.
Yeah.
There are so many other callings we have in our lives that only us understand.
Yeah.
And that is one thing I would also wish people who are dating should know. Let not the society dictate who you need to marry or how you need to do it.
Yeah.
Why? It is only you who knows yourself. People know the small percentage you expose. So when you allow them to tell you, Sonny, you need to be dating this kind of guy who, you know, preaches 10 hours consecutive.
Yeah.
They are wrong, because probably they see you do that, but you want to marry somebody who your character and values align, so that even as I do what I do,
yeah,
we are able to complement one another in one way or another, and we're able to be effective for the kingdom.
So I was talking about identity, a pastor, like two episodes earlier, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I was thinking, if a relationship doesn't serve your purpose, because I talk about identity and it being you understanding your purpose,
mm-hmm,
is that a deal breaker if somebody doesn't serve your purpose or makes you lose your identity in the midst of it?
Yes, it is a very huge deal breaker. I will insist very, very particularly that if somebody is not able to help you grow,
yeah,
to help you become a better person, to help you, like we've said earlier, they're supposed to be a partner and help you achieve. Remember, even as we are serving, we're told the men are the vision bearers.
Yeah.
Yes, it is true, they are the vision bearers. But remember, we still have individual assignments.
Yeah.
My vision needs to complement and submit to his. But that doesn't mean my vision dies. So all of us need to come to a point where if I have a partner, what they do,
yeah,
who they are, makes me become a better person. If somebody constantly brings you down, it is a very, very high denotation that that relationship should not go on. I cannot, the moment I said yes to you, it's because you complimented me.
Yeah.
It's because you told me, you know, Martha, you know, you're so beautiful. Your personality is amazing.
Yeah.
And I felt, wow, this person values me.
Yeah.
I never, came close to you because you told me, Martha, you're just so devastating. You're so,
you make me sick.
Make me sick. There's no day you'll get.
Yeah.
You won't even have a second sitting with such a kind of person.
Yeah.
It's because that person complimented you. And that is the reason that we are there to be together, that you encourage me to become a better person. The moment I meet this person, have I been challenged enough to go to the next level? You know, they're supposed to be your accountability partners. They know this is what you wanted to achieve in the next 2 years. And that is why marriages, they say two are better than one.
Yeah.
When when you're alone, when you fail to achieve what you wanted, when you fail to follow up on what you wanted to achieve, you'll feel like, it's life. But when you're with somebody, they will tell you, no, you are supposed to do this. They
yeah.
will always keep you on toes. They will always ensure that this thing comes to pass. So that is why we insist two are better than one, as long as there are two people who are built and committed towards building each other.
So do you think checklists are overrated? Because I feel like we have a theoretical view of how we would want our husbands to be, right?
Mm-hmm.
But do you think that comes in when it comes to the practical sense? Because
mm-hmm.
I think that's where the mistake comes in.
Mm-hmm.
You're thinking there's this husband on paper, right?
Mm-hmm.
Husband, tick, 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 check, check, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
But these things, when it comes to practical,
mm-hmm.
how do you transform this theoretical part to a practical sense?
Mm-hmm. So I always say, put away all the checklists.
Yeah.
Put away all the checklists. One, you narrow down your choices.
Yeah.
And trust me, finding a spouse requires a very wide range of choice.
Yeah.
To really find that person you want to spend your life with, don't think everyone can be.
Yeah.
Not everyone, trust me. But I always insist, put away your checklists. Leave it for dreamers. Leave it for preschool children who are still dreaming
yeah.
and not understanding life. When you're a grown-up, you know very well that you might never find that package as a whole. We are not denying the role of a checklist,
yeah.
but that is only in the needful areas, not in the areas I really want,
you know,
the areas I really want in terms of, I want a 7-inch or rather a 7-foot guy.
yeah.
I want an 8-foot guy or
yeah.
rather all those things, give opportunity to every kind of person. You never know who will touch your heart. And that is the most important thing. These things that are very invisible is what sustains and keeps you know, long committed relationships? Does this person challenge me? You know, those things that you know you intimately sure do want to share with this person.
Yeah.
Those are the things you can't do away with. The simple majors, you know.
Yeah.
But the minor things that are replaceable, you can live without them. Height does not determine whether the marriage will be sustained. Me being slim or big doesn't determine that now this person is strong enough to because they have a big body, they are strong enough to actually encounter emotional issues. No. People have all their levels of growth, and it is important to just understand the personal package, the character package, more than what you really want to see and all those other things. So for me, checklists are overrated, and it is very important for us to look at what is important that we can't live without.
Yeah.
And then these other things, let us build them. I insist that good relationships are not found. They are built in the daily life.
Yeah.
How you live, how you decide that you're going to treat this human being, how you decide you're going to inspire life into them and, you know, draw light to their lives that they are able to see it is worth being the way you desire me to be.
Okay, let's talk about love, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think we can grow in love? Or is it a feeling you should have an instant feeling before you say yes to this person?
Love has been defined in many ways.
Yeah.
That is now where we get the confusion. But I want to do the definition of love with our main basic reference. Of course, the word tells us what love is very clearly. When you look at love in that aspect, it is very clear, very, very clear that love is more of what I choose to do, not what I feel at the moment.
Yeah.
Therefore, love is something you actually grow in, because you might not be perfect in the actions you decide to take when you're not in the best position to feel like doing it.
Yeah.
Chemistry is very required, because I still want to feel moved when I see this person. That is why I'm choosing you out of all the millions. You know, I still want to feel ecstatic, all those things.
Yeah.
But I'm not saying that is what love is. That is just the emotional chemistry that we have that helps us connect. It's like the leverage God gives us to be able to choose that human being.
Yeah.
But when God calls us to this relationship, what does he desire? To build you as an individual, to prepare you for the greater call, even in eternity. And so what does he want you to do? To choose to act right every single day. And love is when I choose to do what I don't feel like doing at that moment. I know I am so angry, but because I respect this human being, I love this person, I will choose not to do what is congruent to what I feel.
Yeah.
I choose to love this person by being very patient, by being very, very polite.
Yeah.
And in the end, the result is right. So it is very important to understand that love is more of a decision than a feeling.
Yeah.
And love actually precedes marriage.
Yeah.
It doesn't, it precedes marriage. It doesn't precede.
Yeah.
When you get married, love comes after. You know, when you look even at the analogy of salvation, you don't really feel like you love this God for you to be saved. You feel like you need this God in your life. And as you grow, you begin to love him.
Yeah.
You grow in this love every day as you begin to look and be like him.
Yeah.
That is exactly what love is in a relationship and in marriage. You choose to do things to grow into being a better person and choosing to do the right thing even when I don't feel like I want to do it.
Okay, I was thinking of communication. It has been, people have said it's like a lady thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's you to say these things, and they don't, the other gender don't feel the need to say it though.
Mm-hmm.
How important is communication? How does it impact the kind of relationships you have?
Mm-hmm. So communication is, it's like the foundational bits of any relationship. It's very fundamental. And it is always a two-way thing. It's never a woman's thing. Not like deny completely.
Yeah.
Communication has to be between the two of you.
Yeah.
And when do you know you have communicated effectively? When you have reached understanding.
Yeah.
If I'm not yet in understanding with you, I have not communicated.
Exactly.
Communicating is not passing on words from my own self to you. Communication is at the end result, we have understood and we are one mind and we can now get to the next level.
Yeah.
So communication for me is very important, because you're able to understand who you're working with. You're able to have flow of activities because I understand what you want and what you have communicated, what you also need, and all those things I'm able to put them in place. But at the same time, it is important to know that they matter in into the deepest of the smallest activities, yeah. not just the major things. Communicate every detail as long as it involves the other person. If it will affect anything regarding even, you know, sometimes we assume that I might even get late in 1 hour. 1 hour is not long. I will not communicate. Trust me, somebody maybe had prepared something yeah. for you. And you will disappoint them. And that is killing energy that probably next time they will not be very excited about doing anything like that. Why? Anything, they might do anything and they are not sure what will be the yeah. end result. So it's important to communicate every single detail as long as I am involved in any of those decisions. Communicate. Because we are in this life together. Do not dominate that relationship. That relationship is a partnership. There is the head and there is the one who submits. But for it to work, we need to work together.
Okay. So the last thing I want us to talk about is relationships. Because we think relationships should be an end. It's not a working in progress. How are relationships a working in progress? And how should the people demystify that part?
Relationship being a working in progress. I'd say this. Relationships, like we had said earlier, they are built. They are never found.
Yeah.
It is better when you find somebody who is already building themselves, a whole person, and you continue the journey of building. Mm-hmm. If you never work on your relationship, you will remain. We see many marriages. People were so excited. Even people who are divorcing nowadays, no one knew they would end up there.
Yeah.
If I really knew I was going to divorce this human being, I would never have said yeah. anything or even said yes and even given my hand in marriage. People knew, this life is amazing. We're going to do it together and it's going to work so well. But trust me, it is just because we don't grow in it, we don't work in it, we don't partner in it. This is it. If I'm married to you and if you're relating together, the only thing that determines growth is health.
Yeah.
And health is in what you feed in. What do you feed in as the two of you? Do you just sit down and decide we are going to watch a series from Monday to Friday? We're just going to be going out yeah. to every single club that is in town. Every new opening club is always aware that there is a couple we will always visit.
Yeah.
You know, is that the only thing that you feel you want to do together? No, you need to come to a point where you gain knowledge. And remember, knowledge makes it easier. You know, the moment you know something, it is easier for you to understand how to handle
yeah.
any situation that comes across, isn't it?
Yeah.
But the moment you don't understand anything, you will be confused. Even handling a simple conflict would be very, you know, very hard because you don't really know how to.
Yeah.
So knowledge is power. Knowledge is very fundamental in marriage. Keep growing together. Keep adding value. Go to conferences. Go to fellow functions with your fellow girlfriends and couples. Go and make sure you're being built every time. So when you come back, you're power packed to serve this human being and you really want to live together. So marriages are cultivated every day. Just like manna was given every day. You have to remember that love is not, I didn't love you last week, so this week I'm not loving
yeah.
you. It's a daily decision. I have to remember whatever I did yesterday was yesterday's doing. Today, what can I do again for this human being who's in my life? What can I do today? Not what did I do?
So yesterday.
Let me just, you know, rest. I gave you a gift yesterday. That one is for yesterday. So today, if I have any other opportunity, how can I serve this human being? And for it to grow, it's all about that. Growing and the health of that relationship.
Thank you so much, Mother. Thank you so much for joining us. It has been Her Essence on Wema Online TV. It has been me, Sony Mashara, and that's Wema Online TV on all social media platforms. The voice of Wema.
Wema TV, the voice of hope.